It's been working. All right, go ahead.
All right. Hi, everyone. I am Matt Burnett.
And I'm Jeremiah Easton.
And this is our project.
This is really heavy vodka.
To start off, just a little bit about who I am. I have been doing CAD design through SolidWorks all 4 years of high school, and really enjoy it. I am currently an apprentice at Micron, as well as Jeremiah's, and we will be attending CCD next year and CEU Denver following that to study mechanical engineering. I've always enjoyed tinkering with things and building things for practical uses, and mechanical engineering, that's my favorite type.
And like Matt, I've also taken CAD classes all 4 years I've been. But in addition to that, starting junior year and a little bit this year, I've also been working a little bit with object-oriented programming. Last year with robotics, and this year with AB Compsite. And as Matt mentioned, I will also be attending Micron, getting paid to do what I enjoy. So to start off our project, we tried to make a better, more affordable smart pen. Our original goal was to our original goal was to get a product that transfers your handwritten text to digital text and recognize text and enable you to edit it.
So looking at the final goals and outcomes, we wanted to have a real prototype that can trace in real lifetime. We also want it to be appealing to students. We're looking at a demographic from high school and college. That's also why we want to have to save money on compared to other popular products in the market. We want to have the recognition of script. And we also want to actually have physical notes from a realistic. Looking at my five objectives, at the beginning of the year, I wanted to learn how to work with Raspberry Pi 3 and program along with that. I wanted to improve my presentation skills, specifically my public speaking. I've already talked about working with Raspberry Pi. I wanted to learn more about coding and learn the full design process to be able to design the product that we want.
And my project goals were to advance my programming knowledge and skills, better my communication and public speaking skills, despite my appearance, they've improved greatly. I wanted to design a more practical smart pen, better understand text recognition, and successfully create a working product that can help the user in their note-taking.
Going into expert advisors.
We had originally three expert advisors. We ended up losing contact with one of them, but I ended up choosing Seth Howard as mine.
And then I have Justin Chapper. He is a mechanical engineer at Micron. Looking at support advisors, I have Teresa Burnett, mom, crowd right now. I also have my dad for support. My mom's for financial. My brother Brooks to help me look over my project, make sure everything's correct. And also just on a view who is also in our class to look over papers, make sure everything's done correctly.
And for my support advisors, I chose my father, Jeff Deason, my good friend, Shahar Sarah, my other good friend, Jared Stratton, and friend and classmate, Rachel Lee.
Going on to the project summary, I have researched the correct components, and I will get to that later, why I say correct. All components were ordered and received, some of them late, unfortunately, which pushed back my timeline. My pen case and design has been finished and is fully assembled and working. And then my wired circuit inside the pen is also working. Looking at my pitfalls, initially we wanted our design to be through fiber optics. Unfortunately, fiber optics are very expensive and very bulky for what we needed inside of a pen, so we immediately changed our option to go to infrared instead. Over break, I lost time because I was planning to design my components for the project over break, but I did not have SolidWorks on my laptop, so it pushed me back about a month. started out ordering the wrong resistors because we wanted to go with a AA battery, but I did not have enough forward voltage, so I had to change the plan there as well. And then just look at parts we received late, specifically the light, which is one of the most important components. Looking into the accomplishments, though, I have got all my main components, which consist of the camera, the tactile push button that activates the light inside of the pen, the Raspberry Pi 3 to be able to code the light. We also have a preloaded micro SD card for the Raspberry Pi 3 to be able to run our code and use the libraries within that. And then also the actual resistors were the 18 ohm resistors. Just some pictures of what they are, which each is, showing the, here's the specific camera. It's not super high end, but it does what we need for our project. Going into what we were basing this off of. So I found a project that was similar, done by a third grade teacher, and they basically made their own smart board with a Wii remote, and then made their own pen out of a previous pen, just took the internals out and inserted an infrared system circuit inside there. So as you can see, hopefully, this little girl is just drawing on there and it's showing up. So we want to take that and just put it horizontally. Looking into the order budget, our final cost for everything would be $111.01 compared to the product already on the market is about $190. With our price reduction, we can get ours down to 80, exchanging out components such as Raspberry Pi 3. We need that specifically for the Bluetooth, but we did not end up getting to that part of the project, so we can reduce that down to a component that could be $5 instead of $35. Looking at my outcomes achieved, I did finish the research, got the full budget order, finished all of my designs, and completed the circuit and assembled it all inside of the pen. Showing the designs, this is the bottom half of the pen. Got an ink, this is a disc to hold the tactile button inside of the pen. And just the radius of it fits inside of the regular pen at a certain height that will be against the ink cartridge. Looking back, this is the battery holder for our C battery that we decided to use instead of the AA because it had more voltage. This other disc is just simply to stabilize the ink cartridge so it stays vertical and is able to press against the tactile button. I got a top to the battery holder, which I actually unfortunately misplaced. It can't even fit on the top anyway, so it's okay. And then I have the full assembled pen itself, and you can see how every one goes inside each other. I go into the camera case. This is the bottom and the finished design for the Raspberry Pi. And on top we have for the camera, and inside there is a wall that the camera goes through that is mounted to it so it stays in place and stays the way we exactly have it oriented. Also, some people have been asking what this top part is on here, and since we want to do everything based off of Bluetooth, I originally wanted to have an external power source to be able to power it so we can use the Bluetooth to any device we wanted. Since we didn't get to that, that's what that's for, and left it as is for the time being. Full assemble. Now moving to my timeline, in November, researching the hardware, as I say before, I began researching with fiber optics and that fell through. And that pitfall did actually not push my timeline back at all in the research part. So it was mostly just research for November, and I wanted to constantly add to my timeline just as long as we met. Looking in December, I also stayed on track. I wanted to begin buying the hardware at the beginning of December, which we did, but because of Christmas and other holidays, they did end up showing up later, and much later than I expected. I wanted to start my designs beforehand, and that did actually not end up happening. Looking at my designs for breakup on deals are breaking, as I stated before, that did not work. So in January, on the originally work on and finish the design, that changed to just working on it because I have not started yet. Same with everything else here. Just wanted to finish the pen design, fix it if I needed to, which I did. Engineering does not work the first time, as many other groups have stated today. In February, also still pushed me back. I wanted to work on and finish the outside design for the camera case. I was still working on the pen design, finishing up what I need to adjust on it to be able to work correctly. That also goes along with the time lags for 3D printing and waiting for everything to finish. So I was just really finishing up all my designs for February. Going into March, just a few more pushback. We wanted to begin testing later on, so we were able to test at the beginning, and then I needed to fix designs if need be. I did end up needing to fix designs just a little bit on the inside of the pen, just for the discs. They weren't all at the correct dimensions I needed, so I adjusted those. Going into April, I was on schedule working on my presentation and board.
So looking at my timeline earlier in the year, I started off researching Wolfram language, which was used in Mathematica, which is one of the IDEs that came pre-installed in the SD card for use for Raspberry Pi. I found some examples of VR camera communicating with Raspberry Pi. I also found instructions for calling mathematical functions using Python, which I ended up using in the end. I also researched the Python language. I spliced together code and displays it was written. This you'll see at the end of the presentation. Some of my pitfalls were I spent quite a few of the earlier months researching stuff that I never ended up using, so I lost quite a bit of time there. I also had no prior experience with Linux or with Python. So, as I said, in the earlier months, I spent a lot of the time researching specifically recognition programs, which unfortunately we didn't get to. And in December, I initially thought that I would already be starting creating a program. I was still researching. Then in January, I again had a little bit more research to do. I added the research power camera that we were using. I was still researching the Wolfram language, which we ended up not using. I thought I would have a program already troubleshooting it, but that was not the case. I still was looking into the Python and Mathematica, but I did, at the end of February, start to structure a program. I thought that I would look into some storage and access so that we could store the data and have the user access them later. But we didn't get to that either. So instead, I ended up still researching the communication between Python and Mathematica. This past month, I had intended to work on a user interface, but we never ended up getting that far. And as I'm sure Sam and Andy could attest, things like the break, written report presentations, our Raspberry Pi quit on us. It turns out there was too much on it. I just deleted some stuff. But yeah, I would like to do a live demonstration of what the program can do. So, picture on the right you see is...
the picture on your on the right that you see is actually a combination of everything drawn on this paper. So just so we can keep track of everything, the one on the left is what is currently being drawn.
Right, so basically the difference between those is one line of code where everything gets cleared in the version on the left and does not on the version on the right. But right now I'll draw like a star. We'll see how that goes. So it's not exactly a star, but it kind of resembles one. I'll show the picture. I don't know if you guys can see it.
So now there's a few reasons that we can correct this. And the main reason why this is being distorted is just because of the angle that the camera is seeing what we are drawing. Now, the two ways that we can correct this, one would be to just simply raise the camera as we already have just a little bit to get a little bit more accuracy to prove that it is drawing what we are actually drawing on paper. The other way is to improve our code to add a window for what we need, basically turning it to see perpendicular to the camera as is so you can see exactly what you're drawing. If we had a little bit more time, we would be able to get to that.
Basically how this works, is we've got the graphs using the Python graphing utility matplotlib, and what the camera does is it detects IR emitting objects, like the LED on the end of this pen, and it tracks their coordinates. Their coordinates are added to two separate lists, one for the X plane and one for the Y. And from that list, matplotlib plots the points and draws a line between them in the order that they appear in the list. The result is what you see in the figure, or not see. That's supposed to be a circle. But yeah, are there any questions while we roll our good luck?
Any questions? Any at all? Anyone? 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 All right.